If you need to change accounting systems or even make a new file for a fresh start, then this course is the right place for you. But before we get started, you should know that there are two ways to change over from one accounting system to another. You could do a data import, and if you do that, you could use special software and simply copy over all the transactions from the old file to the new file or the old system to the new. There's really nothing to learn other than that software or that feature that copies everything over. However, if you don't import the old data from the old system, it means that you're making what we call a fresh start. And if you make a fresh start, you have to know the techniques that will be taught in this video series so that all your numbers can fit together properly in the new system. Now, if you choose to import data, then you can watch the course on importing data on this very website. It will clearly explain all the options you have for all of the features in QuickBooks and QuickBooks Online that will help you switch over from an old file to a new file or an old accounting system to a completely new software. And again, it talks about features and software that will do everything for you, and there are no special accounting techniques to learn. However, in this course, we don't import the data. We will use the new system to make what we call a fresh start. And that means that everything will be correct as of a declared start date or transfer date. So we know in the new system that we're starting fresh, all areas of data have correct beginning balances as of the start date. That's our goal when we do this course and we transfer everything over to a new system. However, if you need to find older transactions, you can just open the old system or the old file for any information that relates to older past transactions. But don't worry, shortly after the transfer, you will need the old system less and less as you get further into the future. And furthermore, any currently relevant transaction will be in the new system if you use the methods that we learned in this course. So everything will fit together perfectly and you will still be able to access anything you need. So it's clear we must find the ending balances of each account in our chart of accounts from the older system, and those results would usually go on management-related reports. But no matter how antiquated your system is, or no matter how advanced your new system is, the ending of the old must equal the beginning of the new in order for you to know that you did everything correct. Now, don't worry about using two different systems. You'll use the old system to find transactions before the start date, but what you could do is what's called a one-month overlap. This means use both systems for 1 month after the conversion date, and then this way you know for sure that all of the currently relevant transactions will be in the new system. But even if you don't use a one-month overlap, we're still going to show you what currently relevant transactions are and how you need to put them in to the new system. So let's define currently relevant transaction. It's a transaction, in this type of situation, that we know in the future will be used to make another transaction. Now, the setup, you can import or type in one by one only the currently relevant transactions. And then you can use the other techniques taught in this course to bring over everything else. So there's still some data entry to this course, but but only for the ones that you will need immediately in the new system. Some examples of currently relevant transactions are open invoices that we will receive payment later for, unpaid bills that we expect to pay later, undeposited payments that we will deposit later, any open purchase orders or open sales orders for merchandise inventory that we have not yet sent or received, or any incomplete estimates for jobs where you're a contractor doing progress invoicing. You will have to send invoices later for those estimates, and then you will have to get paid for those invoices. So an open estimate for an open contract would be a currently relevant transaction because it's something that you are still working on, and it's something whose details you would need to have in the new system. So how does it all fit together? The numbers must match. Now, the old system's ending numbers must be the same as the new system's beginning numbers for the same date, but for all areas of data, not just the trial balance and the chart of accounts. We know that the main area of data comes from the chart of accounts and the general ledger, but these accounts must reconcile and match with peripheral or subsidiary areas of data. For example, this T account accounts receivable. The total balance must match the total of all the balances of all the customers in the separate area of accounts receivable customer records. It's the same thing for this account, accounts payable. The balance in the general ledger must match the total of all the balances of all the money that you owe to each vendor from the separate accounts payable vendor records. And if we had a merchandise business, it means that there would be a T account in your chart of accounts called inventory, and the balance of the inventory account would have to equal the totals of all the quantities of the inventory on hand at the moment that you transferred from the old system to the new. Now, the first example you see of transferring over to a new system should be a very simple company. It should be a company that has no areas of data besides the general ledger. This means no accounts receivable, no accounts payable, no inventory quantity to track. Examples of these types of companies would be a corner store that just has a cash register and doesn't really track the quantity of their inventory. Or any simple service business that pays their bills on time and only accepts cash payment at the moment that they get the service. In situations like that, it's incredibly simple to switch over to the new accounting system. All you have to do is make one big fat journal entry for the balances in the trial balance of the old system. Just take the ending balance of each account in the trial balance as of the transfer date and make that the beginning balance of the new system by making one big fat simple journal entry. For example, let's imagine this is the trial balance of a simple service company as of the transfer date. All you have to do is make the same debits and credits that are listed here as the ending balances and put them as entries in a big journal entry in whatever system you're transferring over to. The picture on the screen here is the journal entries window from the QuickBooks desktop version of the software. And all you would have to do is open it up and put in the debits and credits exactly as you see on the trial balance, and you'll be ready to use the new system from that moment forward. Even if you were using QuickBooks Online, QuickBooks Online also has a journal entries window. And all you would have to do is enter one by one the ending balances of each of the accounts in the chart of accounts of the old system and put them in one by one in the journal entry window, making sure you have the correct name and the correct amount of debit and credit. Once you save that journal entry, your new system will be ready to use. Let's call this journal entry the main setup journal entry. And you can only do the main setup journal entry only after all of the other areas of data have been put in. That's the way to get everything to fit in together. And I'm going to show you in this course how to set up receivables and payables first before making the main setup journal entry so that everything fits together smoothly. If you're not comfortable with journal entries, you can watch this course, Accounting Journal Entries for Kids. It will give you all the knowledge and skill you need to be able to make any kind of journal entry, especially the journal entry you will need for this course. But no matter what type of company you have, this course will show you how to change over to a new system.